Welcome to Alchemical Science. I'm Jordan, a self-taught farmer, electrical engineer, and physicist who conducts open source research in the areas of unified field theory, soil science, plant biology, radiant energy, neuroscience, and the energy systems of the human body. I'm also a practicing alchemist, and so I try to employ a research methodology that's informed and directed by the hypothesis that there is a universal pattern that can be observed in all aspects of the natural world. We just need to look for it. My research is fully open source, and no new ideas expressed in my videos can be patented. In this video, we're going to talk about what a Roden coil is and why it's unique, and a little bit about how they're made. We won't delve too deep into the mathematics of the coil's inventor, Marco Roden, but I will provide links to his work and also to the work of Tom Barnett and Jamie Buterf, two of Roden's contemporaries, who helped develop the practical application of his mathematics to coils in the description. And I'll add a few other Roden coil aficionados down there as well. So some time ago now, this mathematician Marco Roden publicized his theory, which utilizes Pythagorean-based mathematics and revelations from the Baha'i scriptures to form a new body of mathematics he called vortex-based mathematics. It's reasonably complex at first glance, but it's also surprisingly simple. Roden calls it fourth grade mathematics, and he derides calculus. I encourage anyone interested to check out the links to the work of Roden as his contemporaries in the description. But for the mildly curious or those who are confused by Roden's mathematics, this video should serve as a good introduction to the practical application of Roden's mathematics to coil design. So what is a Roden coil versus a regular coil? A regular coil being either a standard Tesla coil or a Tesla pancake coil, a Tesla bifilar pancake coil, or various other shapes that use the arch form to compress the field into certain geometries. So this is an image of a ferrocell, credit of Ken Wheeler and the inventor Tim Vandarelli. This image is from the book Uncovering the Missing Secrets of Magnetism by Ken Wheeler. So you can check out that book if you want to see the source and more about the magnetic field as it's displayed in this photo. But essentially, this is what a Roden coil is trying to emulate. Although this is just a photo of the magnetic field of a magnet, this is actually the geometry of, you know, the atom, the Planck, the magnetic field of Earth, of human beings, you know, on all sides of the scale, at least according to unified physics. So the idea of the Roden coil and Roden's vortex-based mathematics is to emulate that field pattern and lower the resistance of the coil. So, you know, all these different kinds of coils compress the magnetic field in different ways, and I'll link to an article that explains that quite well. But I won't go into it too deeply now either, but you can check out, you know, what the difference of these geometries is. But I'm going to focus on the Roden coil geometry in this video. But yeah, check out Ken Wheeler and that article if you want to know more about that and the difference between other coils and how they compress the field. So otherwise, there's been a few different kind of Roden coil designs that come out. This one's kind of the standard Roden coil. This is a design by Tom Barnett and his mathematics, based on Roden's mathematics. And it's a nested coil, but a normal Roden coil looks much like this as well. This one is an interference coil design, and the geometry of this one is actually incorrect, and we're kind of working on those mathematics based on Tom Barnett's stuff and this design. I think it was by a user, Spard something or other, which I'll link to in the comments as well, this particular 3D printed frame. But yeah, there was some other types of Roden coil designs that came out when it was less easy to 3D print frames. And there were some flat ones like the Roden Starship coil and things like that. And look, I don't have a lot of interest in those designs. I think they were really just coming up with them because there wasn't easy ways to make toroids, and no one really knew how to apply Roden's mathematics to, you know, making a correct toroidal design. So my focus is really on these types of coils, the full toroid and now we're working on making these the correct geometry, which this one is, although there's a few questionable parts about how many different wires are going through, but we're looking into that, and I'll do another video about that in the future. But yeah, otherwise, this is about minimizing the compression of the magnetic field and those field lines. It takes the longest path, essentially, through the dielectric portal each time, and our dielectric energy is our dielectric field is going to be concentrated in this central area because of the coil geometry. And so all of the other standard coil methods, tuning methods, everything like that still apply, but the geometry of the coil does matter, and we can see that it compresses the magnetic field in different ways. And the Roden coils produce some really interesting effects, which I'll be exploring in future videos as well. The correct proportions for the Roden coil. Again, we're going to go into the mathematics in another video, but you can watch Tom Barnett's video on it for now, and it's really excellent. Kind of explains the basics. It may seem a little esoteric, but once you start just applying it to coils and just downloading other people's designs, it just gives you some factors to look for on correctly designing the coils. So the outer to the inner diameter ratio on these ones, as far as we can tell, is correct, and to the phi ratio. So that's what's important in the Roden coil design, aside from the actual geometry of the toroid. And also the cross-section diameter of the toroid is also the outer diameter minus the inner diameter divided by 2. So those are the two kind of major factors in that. But we'll do a full video on the mathematics a little bit later. So then, there's the nested coils, which this one is. So you can see it actually contains a smaller coil in the middle there. You may not be able to see so well. So Roden talks about, I forget what he calls it, but Tom Barnett calls it the first, third, fifth order, and so on coils. And these are continuously stacking coils that fit together, and again emulate this natural magnetic toroidal field quite well, and concentrate the dielectric in the center. So I'm just beginning to explore these nested designs. We're designing our own new frame, which I'll again be doing a video about and uploading those designs so you can print them yourself and try them out. But for now I don't know a lot about the nested coils. It has some interesting effects, and certainly even this coil isn't tuned at all, which that's something I found out more recently. But it still has a very high wireless transfer of power between the coils, and it steps up the voltage quite considerably for what I'm putting into it. So really interesting effects to explore there. The other thing I'm really interested in is this interference coil design. And as I say, I believe this coil is the incorrect geometry completely. But the point is you can see that I've got these opposing windings in this coil. So it's wound once around the toroid in a full Roden turn in one direction, and then a second completely separate wire is wound in the other direction to kind of create this pattern here. And what that's actually creating is, well, my initial experiments are showing that that's creating a kind of cancelling effect on the magnetic field. So it gives us a bit more play on what the coil can do, and we can adjust the frequency of each channel, I'm calling them, like channel one going around clockwise, channel two going anti-clockwise. And we can produce some interesting effects with these as well that I'm going to explore. And that design was by Jamie Butterf, who I believe, and I'll link to his channel down in the description as well. But in the future, we're going to be doing a video on the mathematics and how to apply that to making the toroids, designing your own or using ours, but being able to verify the mathematics. And also a guide to printing and winding and tuning the coils, both just an individual coil and these nested designs. Exploring these interference coils more, and how we can explore their effects with a frequency generator, etc. And also just on tuning the coils. And I've got an interesting tip there from Nikola Tesla and Eric Dollard about an easy way to tune these rather than the more complicated methods. But we will also go through using an oscilloscope and a signal generator to tune coils as well. So subscribe, like the video if you're interested in that content, and comment if you're interested in seeing more of it, or if you've experimented with Roden coils yourself. I'll link to a bunch of different people involved in making Roden coils in the past down in the comments, including Marco Roden stuff. And that's about all. Thanks.